So the last processor to arrive at the root of the tree, in this case, P5, he's the guy who is going to start the waking up process for everyone. And the way the wake up process works is that P5, having realized that he has reached the root of the tree, and having realized that he's the last one to arrive, because count is already zero after he decremented it, he's going to flip this lock sense flag. So when he flips this lock sense flag, what's going to happen? Two things. One is, this guy, P3, he's waiting on this lock sense flipping. So he's going to be released from the spin that he is on. Of course, P5 has reset the count back up to N to prepare for the next barrier, and it has flipped the lock sense, so freeing up P3, and it is now ready to go down the tree as well to tell his buddies that the barrier is done and wake up everyone along the way. So the wake up starts from the root, and so in this case, P5 and P3, having been released from the root, they come down to the next level, and they're going to wake up the buddies that are waiting at this level of the tree. Remember I told you that this can be a K-ary tree. K happens to be 2 in this case, but for any general K, basically at every level of the tree, there's going to be K-1 buddies waiting here, K-1 buddies waiting here. So what we're going to do is we're going to release that many number of prisoners from every level of the tree. So this is the 0th level of the tree, there's the 1st level of the tree, there's the 2nd level of the tree, and at the 0th level, there is K-1 buddies. At the 1st level, there is K times K-1 buddies waiting. And similarly, as you go down the different levels of the tree, there are more and more buddies waiting to be released. So for this simple example with K equal to 2, so when he comes up here, comes down to this level, P3 is going to release P0, and P5 is going to release P6. And so now we have more helpers to go down the tree and wake up more people. So at this level, only P5 was there to wake up P3. And at this level, both P3 and P5 are there to wake up the respective buddies, P0 in this case and P6 in this case. So once P0 and P6 have been woken up, there are 4 of them now available that can go down to the next level of the tree. And they can go down to the next level of the tree, P0 can wake up his buddies at this level of the tree, P3, his buddies at this level, P5 and P6. And so now all the others, so P1 in this case, P2 in this case, P4 in this case, and P7 in this case, who have all been waiting at this level of the tree, they will all get awakened because of these guys marching down from the root. And basically what each of these guys are doing on the way down is to flip this lock sense flag. So the first thing that P5 did was to flip the lock sense flag over here. That released this guy. And when P3 and P5 come to this level of the tree, each of them respectively flip the lock sense flag that is associated with this data structure. And when they do that, P5 releases P6, P3 releases P0, and now both P0, P3, P5, and P6 on this side, they all can go down to the next level, and P0 can flip lock sense over here, P3 can flip lock sense over here, P5 over here, P6 over here. That is going to release the rest of the buddies, P1, P2, P4, and P7, and everybody has now been released from the barrier, and that signals that the spin is done for all of the processes that have been waiting, and the barrier completion is complete.